Hello friends, and welcome to another episode of Modelman Animation. Today's topic is about fill, stroke, and different ways of representing colors. Here in Moho, I want to draw a shape. The first thing you should do is to just select this draw tool here, and then you have to select whatever you want to draw. In this case, I want to draw a circle. Then you have to choose your own color. I want to draw a blue circle. Then by dragging, you can draw your circle. If I hold down the Alt key, I can draw from the center. And as you can see, if I want to draw a pure circle, I can hold down the Shift key. And now I have my circle. So we call this color that is inside of this shape fill. And the outline of it is a stroke. This time I want to draw another shape, but with different color, maybe a yellow one. And I want to just remove this check here, auto stroke. And if I draw another shape, as you can see, this new shape doesn't have any stroke. It's because we removed this check. Also, if we remove this check and draw another shape, like maybe this color, as you can see, this one doesn't have neither stroke nor fill. It's because we removed those checks. We call this line path. It's just for your own understanding, and if you export your project, you're not gonna see this path. And as you can see, every shape has some points. For example, a circle contains 4 points. To select a shape, you have to choose this tool and then click in the middle of the shape, for example, like this. If I press delete on the keyboard, the shape will be deleted. I can delete other shapes too. But to select this one, I can't just click in the middle, because it doesn't have a fill. To select it, I have to draw a rectangle that covers all of the circle, and then I can delete the path. If you don't like this rectangular selection, you can just use this lasso mode, and then you can draw. And another way of doing this is just disable the lasso mode and just use control. Every time that you hold down the control, the lasso mode will be enabled. Using Shift, you can add to your selection, and if you hold down the Alt, you can just deselect the points. Another cool option is this width option that you can just increase it. And if I choose the draw shape tool and enable the autofill and auto stroke and draw my shape, as you can see, we have increased the thickness of the stroke. For example, let's draw another shape with different widths. You can just see the difference here. To change the color of the shapes, you have to select this select shape here and select the shape that you want to change its color. If it's so annoying for you, you can just remove this checker selection to see the actual shape. And then you can just choose the color that you want, and the fill of the shape will be changed. And if you don't want to fill, you can just remove the check next to the fill option. And another way of doing this is to change the fill option here or the stroke here. You can also change your width. And to change the color of the stroke, you can use this eyedropper next to stroke and go to the color that you want. And now we have the color. Also, fill has an eyedropper that you can use, for example, like this or this. If you want your shape to have the exact same fill, stroke, and width of another shape, you can just hold down the control and click on that shape, like this. Notice that these colors here are not actually colors. It's actually a PNG photo, as you can see, called basic colors. And for example, if you just hold the eyedropper on the lines between colors, you can pick the black color. So be careful with it. Let's change its fill to blue. Another thing is that you can't just type 0 here, because the number of widths should be at least 0.25. If you want it to be 0, you can just remove this check here, okay? And to reset everything, you can just click on reset here. So everything will go back to normal. And To reset your tool settings, such as these changes that happened, you can just hold on the left click on this option and choose Reset All Tools to reset all of them, or choose Reset Tool to reset the current tool. I choose Reset All Tools. Another thing is that you can change this photo. For example, we choose this one, and then we can pick our colors from this photo. Let's just go back to basic colors. This time using the Select Shape tool, I'm gonna choose the red shape. If I click on the color, this window will be opened. By dragging on this bar, I can just choose my color. And using this bar, I can have a transparent shape, as you can see. If you look at here, we have red, green, blue, and alpha. And we also have a code here. I'm gonna explain them for you. Every graphic software has its own model of representing color. For Moho, it's actually RGBA color model. So we have red, green, blue, and alpha. Each one can be a value between 0 and 255. For instance, if you want to add blue to your color, you can increase the value of blue. For the red, green, and blue, 000 means black. And if all of them are 255, it means that the color is white. On the other hand, alpha is the opacity of your color. So if it's 255, you can't see what's behind your shape. Also, the code that I was talking about is another model of representing color called hexadecimal color. It has six symbols, which are actually 32 symbol elements, which is also another way of showing red, green, and blue. Each one of these symbols can be a value between 0 and F. The lowest number is 00 and the highest is FF. For example, to convert red in RGB to red in hexadecimal color, we can say that 9 is 09 and 10 is 0A, 11 is 0B, 12 is 0C, or 15 is 0F and 16 is 10, 32 is 20, 64 is 40. 159 is 9F and 160 is A0. For the 161, we have A1, then A2, A3, until for 255, we reach FF. We always use a hashtag behind the hexadecimal color code. Hexadecimal color code is very useful when you want to have red, green, and blue all in one place. Sometimes you want to bring another color from other softwares to Moho, and this code helps you to have the exact same color that you have in that software. Alright, I hope you enjoyed this video and see you in the next one.